Well, we've been hanging out with him since April when I got back from Potter's Wheel Ministry, where I went to get clean, found God, learned to be a man, all that good stuff.
Amen.
But Wes is my boss at work. He's a dear friend. He's a helper. He's a leader. He's a guide, an encourager. But what I like most about Wes is that he used to be none of those things. And like myself, Wes was caught in a terrible lifestyle. And I'm just being real, he was a person that normal people would categorize as an awful person. Just like I was, just like many of us were. We were both thieves and addicts, liars. We'd do anything and everything to fulfill our selfish desires. And those that loved us suffered most. But thank God he put both of us through the fire. And put both of us through the grinder to sharpen us and strengthen us. To strip us of all of those things that we thought we needed to get through this life. And at some point in our life, both of us in our own way were left with no option but God. Thank God he left us with no option. Because otherwise, I know I would not doubt you would have chosen him willingly. Thank God he saw something. He loved us enough to take away everything and force us to look up. And some of us are too hard-headed to make the right choices on our own. But that's our past.
That's right.
Yes. Wes, I know today is a grinder. Wes, I know today does more than I know any other average man could possibly do for God, for the ministry, for an addict. The Wes I know today is constantly on the phone talking to an addict, talking to someone at church, aggravating his wife at work, somebody to help him, to help other people.
That's right.
Just like he helped me. The other guy that works with us, his other guy that works under him, is an addict. More than any other man I know, he's dedicated. Seriously, I'm around him at least Monday through Thursday for about 14 hours. Every hour of his day, almost, he's got somebody else on his mind. But this is Wes. Y'all give him a hand.